Hi, everybody. This is Randy Suits with a letter and a song. Our letter for today, for 21 January, is Just an Ordinary Day. My darling, Kohana Eve. This has been just an ordinary day with the usual schedule, the expected results, the same great friends for coffee this morning, and the friendly smiles of joggers and walkers on their daily stroll. It has been a time of reflection and study from my Bible reading. The ordinary can be good for us in that it creates no stress. It demands no additional energy. It is satisfied with very little and is effortlessly available. It is also the result of contentment and happiness in the current state of affairs. Simply stated, it is the extraordinary result of the commonplace. My ordinary day is centered on those I love, that is, family, friends, and acquaintances, business associates. These people are the primary source of meaning in my life. When we consider the attraction between human beings, it is easy to visualize the grand scheme of God when he drew up the master plan for a universe. To those who proffer evolution and the Big Bang theory, I say that even the law of averages doesn't support the infinite number of random and accidental mutations to evolve life. What an extraordinary day when God spoke into being day and night, plant life, animal life, and the crowning achievement of his creation when he formed man, male and female, of the dust of the earth. It was ordinary soil until God formed it into a man. Thus, to a degree, even the man is ordinary in his composition. The creative power of God is ordinary for the supreme being of the universe. Creation of the all-knowing God is the essence of his being. For man, we find that God can create a solution for any crisis when he is sought with all the heart, soul, and mind in fervent prayer. He tells us to call upon him in times of trouble. It is during the ordinary times that we forget the absolute control God has over his creation. We foolishly think that we do this or that apart from his influence. Of a truth, God is always standing in the shadows, keeping watch over his own. So let us be grateful for the blessings of God in our ordinary lives, during our ordinary days, in our ordinary lifestyle. He gave us his love and each other, your Kohane. And it is so true, just simple little letters like this, that it is truly the ordinary things where we find out how extraordinary our all-powerful God is, and the Savior that he sent, the amazing amount of love that was required to send the Son of the Most High to redeem and save lost man. We're going to do a song, The Last Farewell, today. There's a ship lies rigged and ready in the harbor. Tomorrow for old England, she sails far away from your land of endless sunshine, to my land full of rainy skies and gales, and I shall be upon that ship tomorrow, though my heart is filled with tears that bid farewell for you. I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word. Yes, you are beautiful. I have loved you dearly, more dearly than a spoken word can tell. I hear there's a wicked war blazing, and the sight of war I've heard so very well. Even now I see the foreign flag raising, our guns on fire as we sail into hell. I have no fear of death, it brings no sorrow, but how bitter will be this last farewell. For you are beautiful, I have loved you dearly, more dearly than a spoken word. Be torn apart upon the sea, I shall smell again the fragrance of these islands on the heaving waves that brought me once to thee. And should I return home safe unto England, I shall watch the English mist roll through the bay. For you loved you dearly, more dearly than a spoken word can tell. Yes, you are beautiful. I have loved you dearly, more dearly than a spoken word can tell. The Last Farewell. Good song. Appropriate for an ordinary day, and how true it is, you know, the things that make ordinary days grand and spectacular is the ones we love, and the love of God in His Son Jesus Christ. Let's be thankful for the many blessings God has given to us. Let's pray for the needs of our nation and the world. That the Lord God would put forth His hand of repression and hold back the wicked and evil hordes that attempt to bring damnation on man. And so now, may the Lord, even the Most High God, be with you in all that you think, say, do, and are. Thank you for being, and God willing, we'll see you again soon.